Hello, cannon defense tubers, and welcome back to Let's Play Shining Force 3 with me, BlueAnkylo. So I hope you guys are pumped up. We're about to have a ship versus ship battle, where we fire our cannons and try to destroy the enemy's cannons before ours blow up. Yeah, it should be fun. So let's give this a go. Now, probably not wise to put Hedva in the front on the cannon. She doesn't have a lot of defense. I believe the cannons can do 10 damage when we get hit. I also think they count as an AoE, kind of like Blaze 2. So a 10 damage up to 5 target sort of attack. I could be wrong, but we'll see. So like Hera might be reasonable. She's got more HP than most people. Let's see if it can aim. I'm not sure if it can, yeah. It doesn't really turn left and right.
Prince Medion, the executors, cannons are out of range. We can't reach them from here.
So, unfortunately, that doesn't work. Oh yeah, we do have some new enemies over there we could check out. Well, I guess, you know, we've seen Wing Knights before in Scenario 2, I believe. Or Scenario 1, that is. They were actually relatively dangerous, so I gotta be careful with them. Otherwise, there's not much. Probably if I reserve, where is he? Old Bernard here with his Robin arrow. He'll probably do just fine at taking down the Wing Knights. They're using lances, so him, maybe Rock to help out for the weapon type advantage. Plus, he's got a range 2 axe, which helps. I'm gonna want actually, you know, technically, Hera is going to be needed to heal people. So Erudo and Hera probably are not going to be firing the cannons long term. I just wanted to test out if we could even hit that one. So they couldn't fire this turn either. So we kind of have a turn to get into position a little bit. I'll put Zero up here for now because he's the only one that can get up there. And Hazuki, like, someone's got to run over to the back cannon. So Hazuki and Campbell kind of their job. Rock, though, is pretty quick. Bernard, we're going to want ready for any, you know, lance birds. Birds with lances. We're going to keep David a little bit back. He's not a bad choice against the birds either. Because he can use his power axe, and he actually does do a lot of damage. Way stronger damage-wise than I would have bet. Let's put Campbell here, I think. And Julian, well, keep him at the back, I guess. Alright, well, let's see what happens. So our ship's gonna slow down a little bit.
Prince Medion, we're losing momentum. They're gaining on us.
Which is silly, because we're supposed to have a tailwind helping us out. Alright, so yeah, I'm not gonna leave. Well, see, eventually, it's gonna take a while. Eventually, they're gonna be firing at us. Maybe even this turn. And I think I want to keep Hera by one cannon and or Yudo by the other, because they're, you know, they're my healers. So I think, well, Yudo has just so much more MP by considerable. So I'm gonna leave Hera kind of back by this one to heal whoever I leave to fire this cannon. It's gonna take a while, but eventually that cannon will be in range. We'll just be broadsiding each other back and forth. But Erudo, I'm gonna send down to help with the more immediate problem. Hopefully that works. Uh-oh. So they've hit the cannon once. I don't think there's any way to check on the health of it. We could technically have Medion fire it, but I think that's a bad idea. We'll probably have
Campbell or Rock. They can make it. Yeah. Somebody who can take a couple hits, basically. Hazuki? 24 defense. Or 24 HP. I'm just looking at HP mostly, because I don't believe... Actually, no, I want to save Hazuki. Well, I say that. Like, Hazuki's going to be one of the ones that's pretty good against the birds when they fly over. Because she's got, like, arrow-type damage. But... yeah, let's start firing back. Okay, so we should be able to see... yeah, he took 10 damage.
Prince Arant, I'm sorry to report Cannon 1 has been hit. However, it is durable and should hold up to several more hits.
Yeah, so... I think we have to kill the Krawort soldiers, basically, so 3 more attacks to destroy that cannon. So you can see, like, it's gonna take 16 shots to kill all 4 cannons. It's actually quite difficult. Because you can only fire each cannon once per round. We don't have any bards or singers or anything that can refresh you and get an extra attack. Yeah, I'm going to try to keep people spread out a little bit. Because I'm pretty sure it does AoE damage when they fire next turn. Probably should have left someone else at the back, to be honest, for the second cannon. I kind of moved everyone up to the front of the ship. Or the back of the ship, that is. Yeah. Alright, so Hedva... gonna keep you relatively safe. Don't think we're gonna be... I think I'm gonna actually pull... let's see. I was thinking someone with the swords would make a good back cannoneer. Because against the wing knights, they're not gonna do much. Maybe Julian even, actually. I say back cannon. You know, this is the front of the ship, so... this guy's coming right at us. We gotta get... prepared for what he does. I would still like to protect Hedva. And we're gonna need some heals before much longer. Alright. So now we get to see what happens when we're on the cannon. Ten damage. Okay, so... as far as I know, I think the idea is if you have someone manning the cannon won't just die as long as they're alive. Now, if no one's on the cannon, I think it only takes a couple hits before they blow up. So, be careful with that. So yeah, like Zero is actually, although he can fly, he's a really bad choice. I wonder if I should try having him fly over... theoretically, he could attack these guys. I don't know if that's even... maybe. I don't know. Maybe. That's what they're doing to us. Oh, they... how's that fair? Look how sideways they shot that. Campbell took the hit. It's fine. Yeah, we're gonna need to heal Hazuki. The guy, the bird will probably go after Medion. What agility is he at? 20. Ooh, he's fast. So it's the beginning. Okay, so the Wing Knights have already moved for this round. That's right. We've already been shot by the Krawort soldiers. So then basically our entire team gets a turn. So we'll want to heal up Campbell and Hazuki. Can... we'll be able to move Uryuto over, that'll be fine. So we can fire either. We definitely want to focus one down first, though. I wonder if Hera could have shot that as well, actually. I'm gonna keep Bernard over here so we can kill the Wing Knight quicker. I'm deciding whether or not I want to put... I think I'm... Brock might take some AoE damage here, but he'll provide defense to two people that might get hit. I think that's a good idea. Can we fire, though? No, this one's still out of range. Okay. Well, that's silly. It kind of... I thought I could test that and still move him somewhere else. I was wrong. But I do need to heal people, so Eruto, you better go before the birds. When does Eruto go? He's gonna go after the bird. How much defense has she got? 21 defense. Currently equipped with a sword. That'll be 16 damage plus a little bit extra because of the weapon type. That could kill her. Dang it! Bad turn order again. And I can't put Hedva up front because that would be really silly. Hera's too far away. We're off to a great start here. Absolutely great start. Maybe should have waited on that, actually. Let Campbell take two cannons, and then... Well, we'll see. I don't know what's going to happen. This is one of those weird maps. Now, she does get the defense bonus from Rock, so maybe she'll live. Alright, well, you know, we started with a save state, so that's great. Absolutely great. So, yes, this is going to be a fun battle. I'm just going to restart it again. Because I guess I could have cut it, but let me just put it at faster speed here. And we'll just zip through the first couple turns again. The fact that Hazuki did not... Like, there was just... I guess... Rock must have had a healing item. I should have used the healing item. It's just the turn order really got me. That's... kind of annoying. We'll just go super speed until we get to the same point in the battle, basically. And I was really hoping the Wing Knight would go after Midian anyway, because... you know, usually the AI likes to focus on him, just... not always. They seem to have some sort of knowledge of if they can get a kill. If there's someone they can finish off, then they'll finish them off. Like, the game knows how much damage they're able to do. Like, the game can calculate it exactly, whereas I'm sort of guessing to some degree. I'm gonna leave. I think I'm gonna plan on leaving Julian to fire this cannon. But yeah, just get through the first couple rounds quick, slightly differently, but... mostly just moving people around, really. Again, I still want to leave Hera back here for dealing with that heal. Because we are going to have to heal people on the back cannon. Well, actually, I don't know. Maybe the AI will just focus on the front. I actually don't know for sure. I just thought... like, my plan was to put, it's probably going to get Zero killed. He died last battle. We'll get him killed again. That'll be fun. The plan was to put one healer on each cannon. Maybe that's not the right idea. I don't know. So I guess technically I could have had Medion take that first cannon hit and defended himself there. Because he went before the soldiers. Now if I put Hazuki here, is it just going to be a repeat? No, because this time I'm going to have Rock heal her. So it's not going to be a repeat performance. Don't worry, guys. So this time... Oh, he only had... I'm hoping he'd have more healing items than that, but... Oh, she hasn't been hit yet. Okay, well, I don't know anymore. I don't know what's going to happen. Things are a little bit off the rails. Also, by the way, probably want to see what's going on from a bit further away. I think middle is the default view, right? Sorry, I'm pressing the wrong button here. I don't know what I want to do. Yeah, we're not able to fire this round. Maybe next round. So this was the turn where Hazuki died. No, it must have been next round, because the Wing Knight wasn't able to attack. Okay. A little bit longer then. Okay, so then we get fired on. Let's see if the AoE is true or not. Okay, it does look like you're safe. So you can put someone standing by the person on the cannon, and they do not get hit by AoE. Maybe I was wrong about the AoE, honestly. I don't know. See, the thing is, I'm not sure if Zero can actually one versus one of these guys. 37, 26. He's only going to do like 7 damage per hit. Like, he can't actually kill a Winged Knight on his own. If I could avoid the Winged Knight and fight the other guy, he'd be okay, but I'm pretty sure I'd just get him killed if I send him on his own. So that shot looks like it... Maybe that's AoE? I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna put another save state down, because... Like, I could pull her out of the way. Need to destroy the one up front first. Okay, Rock still went before the bird, or this time he did. Maybe last time he just got... I don't understand it. Whatever. You can take 14 damage, she'll live. Maybe it'll go after Medion anyway. And we can't fire from this one yet. Okay, so now that we're on this turn, I'll slow it back down. Sorry about all that, guys. I didn't expect Hazuki to just get killed so easily. Speed setting. And yeah, I will admit that when I'm off-camering, I put it on super speed fairly often. Just to save some time. Alright. So we're 20 minutes into the video. Let's see what happens. You know, what I also should have done, I totally forgot again. I should have equipped Hazuki with her shuriken, and she would have taken a little bit less. It's, you know, plus 2 damage or something for having a weapon advantage, right? But Eryudo should get a chance to heal her now, I think. And we should be fine. And then we just need to make sure we kill the Wing Knight before... I really will want to put someone else on that. And someone that doesn't wear a sword and has really good defense should be on that cannon. In fact, you know, Hera... Well, no, Hera's a bad choice because she has to... She has to heal people, so she can't fire. We need someone that has good defense like Hera that I can put on the cannon. And just, they can take 10 damage every turn, and then they don't have to worry about the Wing Knights. Okay, now is this AoE, is the question. What? 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 Sorry, wrong save state. It didn't even do damage, it just killed her! Well, this is the cheapest and worst battle I've fought yet. It was bad enough when, Campbell got knocked into the water by a cannon when I sort of rushed him forward. But since when do they just kill you in one hit? I wonder if there's just certain spots that get targeted by the cannon. Like, I don't know if it's targeting my people or specific spots on the ship. So if you stand in certain spots, you just die. And you don't know about them until... well, until after you've seen people die on them. That's going to be really cheap if that... I'm going to be save-stating like crazy if that's what happens. That is totally not cool. I'm sorry for those of you that hate save-scumming type stuff, but man, that's... Now, if she just dies again, if it just one-shots my, my healer with, like, the most defense in the group right now, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do. Theoretically. So this time, just want to point it out, that this time, Rock did not get a turn to heal her. Just pointing that out this time, that thanks to the luck of the turn generator. Maybe I didn't notice it. I don't know. Maybe it was my bad. I don't want to blame it all on the game. Sometimes it is my fault. Alright, so the front cannon seems to be targeting... the enemy's front cannon seems to target our back cannon. So remember how I previously said that I didn't think it was an AoE shot? I don't know how that even works. It didn't hurt the Wing Knight, but it hurt Hazuki and Eryudo, but not Rock, and it clearly targets the cannon itself. I don't even know. Looks like this is one of those battles where, it's basically a noob trap. You know, first time through, they're just gonna kill you a few times. The only way you figure out what to do is by, you know, playing it, seeing what the AI forces you to do. If there's gonna be specific tiles that, So that did damage in larger than a range 1, like not like a Blaze 2 spell. That did damage like a Bolt 2 spell with an even larger radius. Ouch. Yeah, I'm not terribly happy about my positioning here. I just, like, it's gonna be really easy for the enemy to do more damage per turn than I can heal right now. Really quite easy. I should have brought a bunch of medical herbs. I'm used to this button being canceled. Sorry. Playing different games with different buttons to cancel. Okay, I'm gonna not have his... well, see, once this bird's dead, there's nothing for a fair while, so okay. We need to destroy at least one cannon, and if Hazuki and Julian can both shoot this one, it'll be dead. Then the damage per round won't be so bad.
Prince Arantz, please forgive me. Cannon 1 has taken significant damage, and will be destroyed if it is hit again. Load faster, you fools! We must destroy their cannons.
Alright, yeah. Sure would be nice if Eryudo had Aura, which I might have to give him for this battle, to be honest. All I need to do is promote him and level him up once. I think he'll get aura, so. All right. So, Rock. I'm gonna move him here so that Erudo can stand behind Hazuki. Please tell me I can hit it.
Thank you.
Blow it up. Okay, so that's the one that was targeting Hazuki before should be gone now. Good. And then at the end of the round, we slow down. That's fine. You know, it actually would be valuable as well to have two high agility people on the cannons that could fire before the Krowort soldiers get a turn. That would actually help out. If there's anyone other than Hera that could do that. Alright, so Hera. I mean, I think they're going to attack Julian at some point, but, you know, I don't know for sure. I think we're going to heal up Bernard first, because he's got sort of lower HP than Hera does. Also, you could put people on the... I've got two life rings, so technically I could put two people on the cannons that can regenerate. That might be valuable as well. Alright, we're going to move Erudo somewhere where theoretically he won't be hit by the cannon fire. Should probably put Rock beside him. So that Midian is standing where Rock is and Rock is standing there instead. Alright, so now we can target... So the two cannons here can probably hit us, so we're going to keep firing on the one at front. Because that'll be the one Julian can hit sooner, and then the sooner we destroy it, the less damage we take back. Alright, so the rearest cannon now is firing on Hazuki. So I am glad I took out the front cannon, or else she would have taken two hits, I think. What are you talking about? Does the cannon just... Is this gonna kill Campbell? I don't understand. Because Hera had more than 20 HP. She had full HP when she died. 38. And, like, last time, she was standing on that black spot, and it just insta-killed her. Maybe the cannon fires at a specific spot on the ship twice. And then the first time it does 20 damage, and the second time the tile is destroyed. So if you're standing on it, you're just dead. I don't really know. I don't think I'm going to be able to use Zero to help, though, unfortunately. Like, I can't see him getting past that Wing Knight on his own. If the Wing Knight dies, then I can try, but for now, I don't know. Lots of space. Oh, that was actually bad. Bernard will be hit by the large AoE there, I think. That's kind of a mistake. Campbell can get out of the way. Heal himself at least. Yeah, so my recommendation is to buy a bunch of medical herbs because 10 HP is exactly how much damage most... Oh, that's fun. Most of the cannons are doing 10 damage, so having medical herbs would sort of counter that. Good, so next round we'll be able to destroy this cannon because both Hazuki and Julian can hit it. The problem is next turn we might get hit by three cannons. before we destroy the front one. That's okay. Maybe we'll be all right. Maybe we'll be okay. I'm going to put another different save state down, save state 3. Mostly because I don't want the enemy to just one-shot anybody. I think that's totally cheating. So, okay, Hera. Someone needs to heal Hazuki. That's going to be Eryudo's job. I think everyone else is in respectably good shape. You can heal yourself for now. Bernard will probably take a hit, but he'll be okay. I don't really need to heal Eryudo. As long as he's safe, he'll just regenerate, so that's why I'm not worrying about healing him. There's those three Wing Knights still. How did that Wing Knight take damage? Huh. Alright, but let's keep Hazuki topped up. I'm not sure when, but she might start taking two cannons per round. Perhaps on this round, because of the fact, like, just because of what enemy cannons are in range at a certain time. We'll see. So this targeted the spot where Campbell was standing. And because I put Bernard in the wrong spot, like, I could have avoided that. That was my mistake. So this cannon's actually going to get destroyed at the end of the round. So really, Zero's way behind the ball here. And we're not rushing over to fight Arant. Or he's not going to win against Krivor. So, yeah. I keep, you know, wishy-washy on... what's his name? On Zero. I don't know what to do with him. So, what? How are you supposed to win then? I don't understand this battle. So, Hazuki died, but she didn't actually take damage? And I don't think we lost the friendships with her? What? This battle is dumb. I don't think there's any way we can win this. Because if it is just four flat hits to a cannon and it's destroyed, then this cannon will be like, this one's already taken one hit, so it will just take three more for it to be destroyed. There is no way I can kill three cannons with one in three turns, basically. Maybe even two turns if they double shot it. I honestly don't understand how you're supposed to do this battle then. Plus, I lost Hazuki, which is making me upset. Well, this might be the dumbest battle we've seen yet. See, because the plan was to have this front cannon on the enemy ship destroyed. But Hazuki didn't get to fire hers. Like, it was on this round. But Hazuki didn't even get to shoot. I think this might actually be a battle that comes down to agility. If you do not fire before the Krivort soldiers do, there might not be a way to win. Like, you might literally need to fire on that cannon twice before it gets a chance to fire. Every round. So that you can destroy it and basically... Because you destroy it before it gets to fire, each cannon would lose one shot if you just blew it up before it got a turn on the turn you blew it up. Right? Does that make sense? Like, you know, you're sort of trading fire As long as nothing explodes, you're just trading fire every round. But on the round, you can kill it. If you kill it before it gets a shot, it misses its shot. That way, this one would not have been wouldn't have got a turn. And then, again, it's gonna actually get a second shot that it shouldn't have, because we didn't destroy it last turn, and because Julian's really slow. I think we're gonna have to egress and try again. I'm also trying to learn if the two swats, the one that shot near Campbell and the earlier one that shot by, was it Bernard and Hera? I need to learn if those are static, if they always fire on that spot. Because if it's true, then I just need to keep people out of range of that. Like, if those two black marks, maybe on the first turn you take 20 damage, the second turn it just destroys it. But if you imagine like a range 2 spell focused on that, maybe I just need to keep people out of that range and then they won't get hit at all. That's kind of secondary, though. That's not a big deal. The problem is really... the fact that the cannons are going to blow up, actually. Also, they might be able to kill Julian here. So the third cannon was too far back to hit Julian, I assume. So I think... I don't know what's happening now, because that front cannon should be gone. I guess we're just lucky she had 22 HP. But like, you couldn't have predicted that he was going to fire on that spot. It wasn't like he was targeting anyone. He's just... So you need to know, okay, this spot here by Urudo, that's going to be bad. The spot by the mast, that's going to be bad. The spot right in front of the, whatever it's called, the steering wheel. don't stand there either. There's no way to predict, as far as I can tell. Other than you do the battle once, find out, and then reload. So this is, yeah, F. This battle gets an F out of me. It's already been a really long episode. It's 38 minutes, but I'm going to have to redo it. And I'm just going to do it off camera next time. Because this is pretty garbage, I gotta say. There's no strategy involved. It's just play it through, figure out how cheapskate the enemy is, what spots they target, and then reload it and you'll be fine. I don't even want to waste my items here. This should destroy that, but, you know, like, there's no way that Julian can destroy all the cannons on his own. Even if I can keep him healed up, it doesn't matter, like... In fact, I don't even know if it's possible to keep your rear cannon from being destroyed, just the way it works. I'm not convinced that it's even possible right now. But like I said, I will try off camera a couple times. Maybe I'll do a little bit of Googling to see if there's a some sort of strategy. Like, it's kind of like that one in scenario one where I had to rescue Irene. It just feels like a cheap battle, and I don't know what I have control over that I can use. So now they're targeting. This is probably as far as I need to research. They're targeting... I didn't see exactly where, but near Bernard. I think it might be right beside the other hole there, like just two spots behind the mast, maybe. I don't know for sure. Maybe two spots behind the mast and one over. Bernard's probably gonna die. But I'm just gonna reload this anyway now at this point. Actually, he didn't die. That's nice. If no one loses friendship, then I can just egress out and it's fine. But yeah, you can see the little black spots. You can't stand on them. Yeah, that'll be why Hera died the first time. Is the spots, if you stand on them, you take 20 damage the first turn. And if you stay on them, you die because it's an invalid tile. But it's not even really dying because you don't lose friendship. You just disappear. It's weird. The thing is, well, unless I'm wrong, there's really no way to sort of win this one right now. It's gonna take eight shots to kill both of those. Wow, yeah, how am I gonna be able to destroy all four enemy cannons without losing any? It may literally be impossible. I'm running through my head trying to think of what I can possibly do right now. Because other than the agility going first, I can't really think of anything that will help. Like, I don't think you can heal the cannons. Where's the engineer? Where's Sid when you need him? Julian's still at full. Yeah, and I think around here is when the bird's going to be able to finally attack. So yeah, the bird will probably kill Julian now if I don't aggress out, so we'll probably want to do that. If no one loses friendship points, though, I can just aggress this turn. And I think I know enough now, and I think you guys have seen enough, probably. Yeah, look how important those levels up are. Okay, I think I'm just going to promote Eryudo here. Obviously, he's not getting stats. It's just wasting time here. Let's get out here. So we'll do we're not going to do a promotion party on this episode, but I will promote Eryudo at least, just so you guys can see their first promoted unit. Because if he's not going to get any stats from a level up, what's the point, right? So this is a really, really bad battle for getting level grinding, which is unfortunate because I was planning on getting everyone to 17 around this point. The last battle wasn't very good either, which means, I don't know, I might have to promote people with where they are right now. I'm gonna try, but I was planning on getting everyone to level 17. Like in scenario one, we had a really good battle with the battle with Fial and the big masked monk sort of ambush at one of the F word towns. Symbiosis' hometown. That was a really good battle for getting everyone up to level 17 or so. But maybe this is as far as we get, possibly. And because I need the agility, I might just need to promote people. Unfortunately, I can't really train people up. Like, even if I promote people at level 15, 16, whatever they are right now, I can't just kill stuff. There's nothing to kill on this map. So anyway, long episode. We've got Eryudo, he looks a little different now, he's got better stats, and he will get a lot of stats on the next few level ups comparatively. That's, you know, that's why leveling up or promoting up is so important. Now he's going to get plus 2, plus 3 for his stats when he goes to level 2, 3, 4. So we can expect his agility and defense and attack to... Oh, thanks, ship. They'll all go up by like 10 points in the next few levels, and that'll make a huge difference. And he will learn a very important spell next level up. Also, I think his healing should be higher, so I think he got a little bit of a numbers bonus there. His resistances should be better, and his healing numbers a little bit higher. Alright, well, I'm gonna try off camera. I don't want to promote people until I'm level 17. Like I've said, we're sort of missing out on stats. Some people are very close, some people aren't, and I really wanted, like, okay, spoiler alert, Julian leaves after this battle. I really wanted him to promote before he leaves. But I don't know if I'm going to be able to pull it off. I need to find a way to deal with the cannons, so I'm gonna go try that out off camera. Thanks for watching. You know, if you've got some suggestions, leave it in the comments and I'll discuss it with you. Unfortunately, you know, I'll probably have recorded it by then, but, you know, I'm still interested if someone has a great idea. Anyway, see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.